So what's with the ribbon on your head? Here's a couple things that I'm working on currently. Openings, actually. Maybe one of them's just kind of me rambling. This is stuff I'm writing. Stuff I don't really care about. I'm not going to put anything I really care about up, read it or anything. But this stuff are like scrap projects. Just wondering if you have anything you would like to add. Let's do this one together, anyone who sees this, really, at any time. I will, I'll use what you give me. Okay, here we go. Once again, it's an opening to a story. If you have ideas what to do, or an idea for a story you'd like to have written for you, that you think this could be a good springboard for, go ahead and send me some thoughts. Okay. Way. Once, very long ago, to the emerald-backed fly, gleefully wringing his sticky little hands on the windowsill, there was a nasty, awful little place. An enormous thing, little thing, to the little huge gray thing that accompanied it on a very long walk around a very large and very bright light. A walk that seemed like it would go on forever to the things that walked about on the walkers. It was always raining there. There being the place of the first, the one mentioned that was huge to flies and small to big gray things and seemed to have an unstoppable drive to walk around lights all the time to the things that walked around on it. Now that's not to say that there weren't places that were dry. No, why, there were dry places everywhere, but no matter what, it rained and rained forever. Anywhere it wasn't more or less dry. Oh, it was a terrible place, much like a sweaty squat man slouched into a gravitational easy chair, his few clumps of hair that still remained seeming to be joined to his thick glasses, as the moisture that heaved out of him with every labored breath swam across every inch of him glistening in the tubed glimmering of the big bright light. He sits alone in the dark, staring at the light before him, simply existing. The glow illuminating the one color he seems to have turned on account of the moisture, the sparse patches of undrenched areas, an A-cut t-shirt and some boxer briefs, barely set off from the rest of him due to the moisture's color on him. All sorts of nuisances crawling about all over him, sucking up this and digging at that. Anyhow, there was once this place like all that. It was no good there for decent folk. Everyone was a dagger tooth and a fox eye and a lizard brain. They traded everything for the right to put pieces of themselves into each other and make the others feel like less of anything they might hope to be by also doing everything they could to seem like something more than they indeed were. They weren't fooling anybody. But nonetheless, they all played along for the most part. Lots of folks tried to figure it out, pondering until their brains were getting idea tummy aches. Just why, oh why, the dagger-toothed, fox-eyed lizard brains acted like this. But we all have to play along here. I mean, they do there. So everybody usually just gave up on the subject. This was later rationalized as the subject being found to indeed be quite rude and unfitting of proper lizard brains to mull over. So this whole vying for breeding rights deal is going down, and the dagger-toothed fox eyes are staying real peeled-like to try and catch the one being more lizard-brained than the other. And this whole mess just refuses to quit. I mean, it went on for thousands of long walks on the part of the awful place around the big light. Here and there, through the course of all this, the dagger-toothed fox-eyed lizard brains accomplished things, stacking dirt and rocks and smashing shapes out of big rocks that looked like things they'd wanted to put pieces of themselves into. And a few of them even came up with a few good ideas that tricked the most dagger-toothed fox-eyed lizard brains. These ideas were the most lizard-brained of all. You see, the ideas that tricked the most dagger-toothed fox-eyed lizard brains were head-hatched by the big scaly twix-eared parts that had come to notice that their unquenchable desire to put pieces and parts into the dagger-toothed fox-eyed lizard brains of their choosing that seemed the most appropriate to what they'd been taught to look for, or vice versa, don't last forever, and this made them sad. They also noticed that Daggertooth Fox-Eyed Lizard Brains don't hardly last much longer than about 80 long walks on the part of the awful place where it is where it always rained, no matter what, somewhere, and this made them sad. Well, if you would be so kind as to believe something I said to you, and even were it just this one thing, it's that above all else, Daggertooth Fox-Eyed Lizard Brains, shit, hate being sad. Well, also they hate rejection. Rejection of any kind to these folks was like a load of rocks on their backs that they never could get rid of. Anyway, these big lizard brains come up with this fantastic idea that there was a great big dagger-tooth fox-eyed lizard brain that loved everyone and didn't even want to stuff them all full of its parts, and it also never ever died. And if they talked to themselves enough, believing that they were that the big dagger-tooth fox-eyed lizard brain was on the party line, they would last forever too. For whatever reason, this made them all push metal bits through each other's internal organs and squish the blood out all over the place, making an awful big mess for thousands more awful place light walks. Why? Your guess is as good as mine on that one, pal. Another good idea, the idea ranchers mashed together between naps, was that all the lizard brains should live a certain way so as to not as to let all the lizard brains feel all right, and the lizard brains with the most shiny things that their parents died clutching to their wrinkled hides should get more things, and also they should make all the decisions. The lizard-brained inhabitants of this awful place really seemed to enjoy this idea. They liked it so much they celebrated it much the same way they had celebrated the inception of the big lizard brain idea. They pushed more metal bits through one another for years and years. Eventually they even became so engrossed in their joy, spilling over with inspiration, that they figured out how to turn whole huge bodies of their rock stacks and huge groups of other lizard brains into carbon dust that gave things cancer. The dagger-tooth fox-eyed lizard brains fucking loved this idea. So anyway, there was this awful place, and here I have a story about it for you. Now that's where you come in. I think I may have skipped some words and stuff. Either way, most of it doesn't make much sense, and I really don't want to reread this. So, if you would like a copy of this, you can't have it. But if you'd like me to do it again, ask me to do it again. I'll do it again, but probably not today. My mouth's all dry. I keep getting spit between my lips.